Hello. Okay. Yep. Good morning. We welcome you to this commemorative day, the graduation ceremony for the class of 2022. I am Isaac, and this is Davida, and we are joined by our fellow vice captains Zoe and Kaushik, and it is our pleasure as the 2022 school captains to host this prestigious event. We are incredibly lucky to be joined by our loved ones, and extend the thank you to our fantastic teachers, our principal, Mr. Connor, and our Director of Education, Mr. Erickson, here to celebrate this key milestone in our lives. We have come together to celebrate the end of 6 years of schooling. Today is a reflection of the determination, the commitment, and the outstanding efforts of the schooling to which the Year 12 graduates have dedicated to our school.
It is on important days like this that we acknowledge the traditional custodians of this land. I would now like to invite Cyan Denning, Ashley McDermott, and Seth Fields for the acknowledgement of country.
Hey. Oh, it works. Good morning, Warumbi, Mitigar, and Mudgeon. Welcome family and friends in Darug. I am Cyan Denning and I am a proud woman of the Kamilaroi Nation. This nation incorporates Tamworth, Narrabri, Walgett, Lightning Ridge, Moree, Gunnedah and Singleton. My two friends, Ashley and Seth, who are also of First Nations descent, and I would like to acknowledge their background as being Aboriginal descent. Today I would like to acknowledge the Kabikal people who are the traditional custodians of this land. I would also like to pay respect to elders past, present and emerging of the Darug Nation and extend that respect to other Aboriginal people present. Yanu and goodbye.
Thank you. Now for the principal's address, would you please welcome Mr. Khanna to the lectern?
Good morning, everyone. Before I begin, I too would like to acknowledge the Gabrogal clan of the Darug Nation as the traditional owners and the custodians of this land on which our school and community stands. I would also like to pay my respects to their elders, both past and present, and extend my respects to any Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander people present here today. In the past, our previous principal, Mr. Weatherstone, has sung to the graduating class. I was given some ideas that I could come to the stage dancing, do a worm dance, but none of that is going to happen. I did try to practice singing for you guys, but the more I practiced, the more I was convinced that this world is not ready for my singing. So you will have to put up with my speech, but I assure you that this speech comes from my heart. I stand in front of you as your proud principal, and it gives me great pleasure in welcoming our Year 12 graduating class of 2022, their parents and their carers, families and friends, and our students and staff to celebrate the achievement that comes after finishing 13 years of schooling. Six at this school, but in total there were 13 years of your schooling. A special welcome to our honored guest, Mr. Dace Ellertson, Director, Educational Leadership, Glenfield Principals Network. Mr. Ellertson is a staunch supporter of public education, and he oversees 21 schools in the Glenfield Principals Network. He has a genuine and a keen interest in our school's growth and success, and our school benefits immensely from his support and from his leadership. Thank you, Mr. Ellertson, for gracing us with your presence and making this ceremony even more special for us. Also, a special welcome to Deputy Principals Mrs. Violi, Mrs. Robinson, and Mr. Brennan, and your year advisors, Mr. Patterson and Ms. McHale, who have worked tirelessly with you behind the scenes to ensure you achieve your potential and become the success stories of John Edmondson High School. This year, yet again amongst many uncertainties, hosting this event certainly presented its challenges. This special event would not have been possible without the incredible effort of many people. I would like to thank Mr. Lloyd and Ms. Ryan for their massive organization they have put into the graduation today. A special thank you to Mr. Kevin Campbell, who you would have seen running around, who has provided us with advice and assistance in so many ways to make this event possible. Mr. Chavez and Ms. Rositano for all the musical and sound work. To Mrs. Owen, Mr. Hilton, and Mrs. Zulik for the creatively produced yearbook for our students. To Ms. Day and her entertainment crew in staging and live streaming this event. Year 12s, on your seats, you would have received a special gift. The handmade cookies wishing you congratulations. They were specifically made for you by Mrs. Khanna with her Year 10 food tech class. A phenomenal effort, but a small token of appreciation for you all. Also, thank you to Mr. Patterson, Ms. McHale, Mr. Brennan, Mrs. Violi, and Mrs. Robinson for helping with the arrangements leading up to this event. A special thank you to Mrs. Franks, who has put the program and the presentation you see here together with such great professionalism and flair. And finally, to all of our amazing office staff, superbly led by Mrs. Smith and recently by Mrs. Farrell, who have worked tirelessly over the past few weeks to finalize all Year 12 arrangements. Please join me in acknowledging and thanking these extraordinary and very talented people within our school. Okay, our school's motto is courage and integrity. When we talk about courage, this year, our courage was tested in a way like none other. The loss of one of our family, D. Young Antwi, in Year 7, who lost his life on the 20th of May due to a medical episode. The way you all supported his older brother in Year 12, Cross, and comforted so many other younger students while you were still grieving yourselves, was an outstanding display of your courage. You definitely redefined the meaning of courage for this school. And as for integrity, your academic and sporting integrity has been regularly recognized by your teachers, your family, executives within the school and outside the school. However, your leadership integrity was noteworthy when you volunteered for running the anti-bullying and support workshops for our current ES7 students all by yourselves. I would like to pay a tribute to our 2022 school captains, Devita and Isaac. Devita is passionate about empowering women to take on leadership opportunities within the society. And Isaac is committed to raise awareness amongst young people about mental health. Along with Devita and Isaac, I would also like to acknowledge our vice captains, Zoe and Kaushik, who have superbly led and worked with the leadership team and have demonstrated on numerous occasions their outstanding leadership and personal integrity. The leadership team of 2022, they have been extremely active in being positive role models for the school, raising funds and awareness for very worthy causes, and have had a constructive voice in making positive changes for our school. They have been excellent ambassadors and have done our school immensely proud. Please give them a round of applause. I'll give you some statistics for your cohort year 12. There were 151 students in your cohort. 131 of you were born in Australia. 20 students born outside Australia in 11 different countries. It is amazing that 80% of you, that's about 120 of you, can speak a language other than English. Miriam Coca, you were the oldest of your cohort, 18 years and 8 months. Sean Chant, you were the youngest at 17 years and 1 month. Average age of your year group is nearly 18 years. And 18 years ago, while your parents were overjoyed in celebrating your birth, Facebook and Gmail were launched. Greece hosted the Olympics, and the famous movies Shrek and The Incredibles were launched. And lettuce was only 49 cents a head. And a statistic that you all achieved, and one that I am very proud of, an absolutely proud principal when it comes to this. Each and every one of you, every single one of you has achieved the HSC minimum standards for literacy, numeracy, and writing, and will be receiving your HSC credential. This is a massive feat, and I'm very, very proud of you all for this achievement. A big thank you to Ms. Tran, who worked tirelessly to ensure that all of you received your HSC credentials. Also, thank you to Ms. Zulik, Ms. Halbert, and the learning support team, who worked tirelessly to provide you with this support to build your skills to achieve this accomplishment. I think that's a round of applause for our graduating class. You all are such incredible group of students who have achieved so much as individuals and as a group. Every year, without fail, I hear your year advisors debating passionately about how good their year group is, how committed these students are, how much they have achieved, how much they have matured, and so on. And this year was no different either. They, along with your teachers and myself, speak so highly of you and your achievements, for your hard work and your commitment, for being outstanding role models, for being passionately involved in community work. The list is endless. You all are so resilient. You survived floods, blackouts, rain, COVID. The fact that you all made it here, decorated with awards and accomplishments, is a testament to your perseverance and your commitment to excellence. So well done. Lately, quite a few of you came to me to thank me for giving you support over the years and for being patient with you. And some of you even apologized for being painful at times. What impressed me the most was the appreciation you all had and the words of wisdom and advice you sought. So here it is. Many believe that HSE is all about bands 5 and 6, and that is how success should be measured. So wrong, so untrue. Success can't be measured by your bands, but if I was ever to go by their belief, I would give you all, every one of you, the highest band possible for taking on board the advice given to you and turning into mature and responsible young men and women. This is how amazing you all are. During the next few weeks, as you sit down to do your exams, you owe it to yourselves to work hard and do your best. But know this, these results will not be a measure of you. There are no exams or assessments that will even come close to showing what you are capable of. Exams will test your memory and your understanding of a particular concept. They cannot test your intelligence. They can't test the person you are. They can't test your creativity, your courage, your resilience, or your leadership. You are the potential for the greatness. You have the potential for the greatness, whatever that looks like for you. Don't let your marks or grades tell you otherwise. I must say education is important, but some of the most powerful things you learned at school wouldn't be found on the periodic table or between the dog-eared pages of your maths book. Your education has given you the capacity to have a voice and a presence, whether that's through the way you use words, the way you create, the way you play sports, or you perform. Or maybe it is something else. It has shown that setbacks are temporary. Disappointments do not last, and enough courage can lift you out of anywhere. It has taught you about the relationships to seek out and the ones to steer clear of. And let me tell you, you will come across plenty of those. Hopefully, above all else, it has taught you that you can learn anything and can do anything when you put in the effort. A wise man once said, in school, you're taught a lesson and then you're given a test. In real life, you are given a test that teaches you a lesson. Remember, the potential in you is breathtaking, whether you have realized it yet or not. There will be choices, twists, and turns in your path, and a lot of that path won't be anything that you have imagined. Sometimes things will work out exactly you planned it to be. And sometimes things will be different. It is in the unexpected that the magic happens. So take notice of your disappointments, because they are often opportunities disguised as something else. To the staff, thank you for your hard work, your patience, and above all, your dedication. I have said repeatedly at various forums, and I say it again, you are by far the best team of professionals I have ever worked with, who are so committed and take pride in enriching our students' learning experiences, both within and beyond the classrooms. Students, remember that day, the first day of your high school, or the time when you had your first crush, or the second, or maybe the third, and you were not sure what to do, and when you had an argument with your friends, or when you did not do well in your assessments, or you didn't get the marks you wanted. Guess who was there right behind you, supporting you? It was your teachers. Today, your teachers are filled with pride, joy, triumph, and a feeling of completion for successfully getting you through these high school years. Yes, if you look around the room, there might be some sighs of relief in some cases. Look carefully and you might even see a slight moisture in the corner of their eyes. After all, they have looked after and over you for 6 years. And now they are hoping you will go on to fulfill your dreams, your hopes, and your aspirations. On behalf of all of you and your parents, I thank all of our teaching and non-teaching staff for their unwavering support of our graduating class of 2022. To the parents, year 12, you might recall a gentle hug or words of encouragement from your parents in getting an assignment completed. You may remember asking for some advice on a complicated maths problem, only to realize that mom and dad had no idea about it, but they guided you in the right direction. Let's not forget all those parent interviews or the taxi service mom and dad provided over the years. Your families are extremely proud of you. You cannot imagine the sense of relief they are experiencing right now. This is probably the perfect time to ask for money. Parents, it has been a long journey for you to see your children grow from being babies to the fine young adults. You supported your children through their educational journey, shared the stresses of exams, no doubt through a range of tears, tantrums, and laughter. I thank you for putting up with your children from their nose-picking days to raging hormonal breakdowns. I can see and tell that each and every one of you is immensely proud of your child's achievements. You should be proud of your child, and I am too. I couldn't be more proud to be associated with them and see them become exceptional men and women. On behalf of your children and their entire school family, I salute you and I thank you for your commitment, your hard labor and patience in steering them to success, and above all, your love and support, which at times went unnoticed. So thank you. To the year 12s, we are behind you, cheering you to the finish line. You might be feeling stressed, overwhelmed, confused, tired. We understand that. But keep going. Give it everything you've got. You're nearly there. And know whatever happens next, you've got it. You've got what it takes for an amazing life. I wish you luck, but more importantly, I wish your path is not too difficult, but challenging enough for you to learn new skills to be successful. I wish you face these challenges with confidence, along with the wisdom to choose your battles carefully. If someone tells you you can't do it, I expect them you prove them wrong. Strive to be the best version of yourself and be phenomenal. I wish you adventure on your journey, and may you always stop to help someone along the way. Be true to yourself, be kind, and always remember how much you are loved. Well done on getting through the easy part of life. Finally, now that you've graduated, just remember, your bosses do not usually accept notes from your mom and dad. You are out there by yourself. It saddens me that you will be leaving us today, but it also excites me, for I know I will be hearing your success stories. So graduating class of 2022, I bid you farewell, and I wish you all the best for your future endeavors. I will miss you all dearly. Thank you.
From
the city that we love. Great clouds roll if you close your eyes, does it almost feel like nothing changed at all?
Hello, okay. We would like to invite Mr. Patterson to the stage to present his year advisor address.
Year 12 of 2022. You have been my favorite year group since I started teaching at John Emerson High School some 12 years ago. The sense of humor you all have has made me laugh more times than I can count. Since the very beginning, I've known that you're all a funny bunch and you're all good kids. I'm sure. In year seven, back in 2017, you all came from a variety of schools, but you quickly got along. I recall you all being a competitive bunch, particularly those in the T and O classes. There was constant movements between mixability classes and the T and O groups. Many students who started in mixability classes were able to be placed in the extension classes by performing extraordinarily well and elbowing their way into more challenging class settings. Year eight was a time when students started to break out and be more confident and silly. Still though, there was never any malice, and through a process of monitoring cards and visits to the deputy's office that I'm sure Mr. Carner can look back on fondly, there was great improvement. The difference between the behavior of some students back then compared to now It's a testament to the efforts they made to improve themselves, and they should be proud. Typically in year 8 or 9, students really start to have a decline in behavior quality. And this is what we expected for year 9. What quickly became apparent though, is that year 9 was not going to be the tough year, and that the behavior problems of 2018 were as bad as it would get. Mrs. McHale said to me, "We were waiting for the other shoe to drop, and then it just didn't. I'm very happy that the lessons my year group has previously learnt were still sticking in 2019. Year 10 became defined as the year of end warning letters. At first it was a trickle, then quickly it became a flood. So many students were getting end warning letters for incomplete classwork or missing assessment tasks that it became a farce. Through hard work though, many year meetings and constant follow-up, we all managed to get this under control. Some students instead chose to go off to work or TAFE. However, they all left with positive memories of the school and were happy with what had been done for them during their time here at John Edmondson High School. 2021 was when year 11 started and students became seniors for their final journey to the end of school. Over the course of the next 2 years, which went extremely fast, the school saw young adults emerging. Results started to get stronger, behavior issues became almost non-existent, and I'm proud to say that the year group became more resilient than I had ever hoped for. Today, in 2022, I can say with full honesty that I am proud of the young adults you've all become. Each and every one of you is more than worthy to be finishing school here at John Emerson High School. You have exceeded my expectations, and I believe with full confidence that you will prosper in whatever undertaking you pursue beyond high school. I'll leave you with some quotes that have been added to my classroom wall over the years. "You learn nothing in life if you think you're right all the time," Joshua Nichols. "Make sure everyone in your boat is rowing and not drilling holes when you're not looking. Know your circle," Artin Hasher. "Accept no one's definition in your life. Define yourself," Nicholas Karachi. "Risking something is better than regretting it," Nishal Singh. "All that matters is how you see yourself," Tristan Tai. And finally, this is one of my favorite quotes, and it's the first quote you can see when you enter my classroom. It's from Denise Shefke in 2018. "If you think school is a joke, you will become a joke." I wish you all the best, and I look forward to seeing what becomes of you all. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Patterson. We'll now commence the presentation for the Year 12 certificates. We'd like to call upon Mr. Connor to the stage to present the awards and call to the stage Mr. Patterson to announce the recipients.
Daniel Ahmed.
Yeah.
Mohammed Albiati. Harris Ali. Newman Ali. Naba Almiahi. Hussein Amul. Amani Aljam. Noor Alkus Hamo. Shanaz Al-Sablani. House Captain Elliot. Bronze medallion, silver medallion. Owen Armin. Sorry. Ruwan Armin. Sorry, there's a typo on my one.
Thank you, sir. Appreciate it.
Sorry, I read the typo. Julie Anakin. Cross Antwi. Achievement in sport. Katerina Anortovic. Achievement in sport, bronze medallion and silver medallion. Nana Awuku, bronze medallion. Isabella Bejanov, bronze medallion. Ben Barber. Louise Barton. Volkan Benturk. House Captain Elliot, Achievement in Sport. Axel Berry. Rhea Bandvakar. Bronze medallion, silver medallion, and gold medallion. Devita Bharti. Achievement in sport, bronze medallion, and silver medallion, and gold medallion. Also, formal committee, yearbook committee, and student leadership. Myrna Barnan. Bronze medallion. Jake Block. Bronze medallion, silver medallion, achievement in sport, 100% attendance 2022, and 100% attendance 2017 to 2022. Really good. Christian Borg. Achievement in sport. Theodora Budiono, bronze medallion, silver medallion, and first in business studies. Tatiana Carmona, Diana Corona, bronze medallion, achievement in sport, House Captain Elliot, and first in community and family studies. Joseph Cham, achievement in sport. Sean Chand, bronze medallion and achievement in sport. Shahil Chettier, achievement in sport. Unfortunately, Jasmine Cracky is unable to attend today. However, she has achieved a bronze medallion. Dylan Chum. First in business services. Liam Common. Haley Cook. Nicholas Karachi, bronze medallion. Alex Kozis. Tanara Craig. Dylan Crawford. James Catali. Dardan Dardania, bronze medallion. Verena Demirtis, bronze medallion, silver medallion, gold medallion, platinum medallion, school leadership team, formal committee, and yearbook committee. Cyan Denning, bronze medallion, achievement in sport, and house captain for Elliot. Thomas DeScala, bronze medallion and achievement in sport. Elissa Elchami, bronze medallion, achievement in sport and first industrial technology timber. Talia Err. Ali Fali. Seth Fields. Adam Gauci, bronze medallion. Unfortunately, this student is unable to attend. Darko Golub, achievement in sport. Charlize Grattan, bronze medallion, and first place in hospitality, food, and beverage. Saeed Abdullah Haider. Elham Hares, bronze medallion. Tiana Harkins, bronze medallion, silver medallion, achievement in sport, and house captain for Fraser. Alicia Hong. Artin Hauser. Achievement in sport and house captain for Fraser. Annette Huang, bronze medallion and first place in music. Kirit Hanjan. Zake Hussain. Nishadi Ibat. Nirma Ibrick, achievement in sport and house captain for Fraser. Noura Jaff, bronze medallion. Jiraj Jigdev. Jovan Jankovic, achievement in sport. Rhea Jaden, bronze medallion. Nikhil Jit. Akua Johnson. Bianca Johnson, first in English studies. Vasily Jovankovic, achievement in sport, student leadership, formal committee, and the yearbook committee. Shantae Jury, bronze medallion, silver medallion. Liam Keyes, achievement in sport. Nishab Khan, bronze medallion and silver medallion. Unfortunately, he's unable to attend. Semrat Khatri, bronze medallion. Carice Kapongzi, bronze medallion, silver medallion, gold medallion, platinum medallion, first in chemistry, first in English advanced, first in English extension one, first in mathematics advanced,
first in Mathematics Extension 1 and first in Physics. Luke Koenig, bronze medallion and silver medallion. Miriam Coker, bronze medallion, silver medallion and gold medallion. School leadership, formal committee and yearbook committee. Aiden Kudozovic, bronze medallion and silver medallion. Arpit Kumar, bronze medallion, silver medallion, achievement in sport, and first industrial technology timber. Also, student leadership, the formal committee, and the yearbook committee. Evangelia Christus, we will now have a brief intermission for the school performance.
Congratulations to graduates. Thank you, Mr. Patterson and Mr. Connell. We would now like to present to you a performance by the HEC Music Class of 2022 singing Time of Your Life by Green Day.
But a lesson learned in time. It's something unpredictable, but in the end it's right. I hope you have the time of your life. Time. Tattoos and memories. what it's worth. It was worth all the while. It's something unpredictable, but in the end it's right. I hope you had the time of your life. It's something unpredictable, but in the end it's right. I hope you had the time of your life. It's something unpredictable, but in the end it's right. I hope you had the time of your life. Thank
you to the music class for their exceptional performance. We would now like to continue with the presentation for the certificates for our fellow graduate students. We would like to call upon Mr. Carter to present the awards and invite Mrs. McHale to the stage to announce the awards.
We would like to welcome up Yasmin Labadibi, who has received her gold medal, her silver medal, and her first in work studies. Next, we'd like to welcome up Choi Lee, who received a silver medal, a gold medal, an achievement in sport, and was house captain of Fraser. Next up, Henry Lim, who received an achievement in sport. Anita Lim, who received a bronze medal, silver medal, and gold medal, as well as the yearbook committee, formal committee, and student leadership. Tara Livermore, bronze medallion. Olivia Mai, bronze medallion, silver medallion. Lucas Martinez, who is in yearbook committee, formal committee, student leadership, has his bronze and silver medallion. Emmanuel Mattingale, who has a bronze medallion and an achievement in sport. Next up, Michael Mattingale, who has his bronze medallion, has an achievement in sport, and was house captain of Freeman. Next up, Miroslav Matichik, who received his bronze medallion. We'd like to welcome up Ashley McDermott, yeah! Coming up, Joshua McRae, who has his bronze medallion and an achievement in sport. Next up, we have Dia Mehta, who has her bronze medallion, silver medallion, gold medallion, and platinum medallion. Next up, we have LeJane Murphy, who has a bronze medallion, silver medallion. And Malik Murphy, who has his achievement in sport. Let's welcome up Kalani Tesimawala. And Alessandra Morales. Welcome up Alessandra Morales. Come on up Kiasha Newell, who's received her bronze medallion, silver medallion, and an achievement in sport, as well as yearbook committee, formal committee, and student leadership. Please come on up Joshua Nichols, who's received an achievement in sport, was house captain of Freedomen, and was first in sports, leisure, and recreation. Come on up Celestin Nuka, who received his bronze medallion and an achievement in sport. Please come on up Thado Zamande with a bronze medallion and silver medallion. Congratulations, Talia O'Neill. Welcome to the stage, Samuel Opokudaka. Coming up, Luca Palazzolo. Who has received a bronze medallion, silver medallion, and a sports achievement. Welcome, Edwin Pangser, who's received a bronze medallion, silver medallion, gold medallion, platinum medallion, and an achievement in sport, as well as was house captain of Freeman, 100% attendance 2022, was on student leadership, the formal committee, and the yearbook committee, and has a first in information process and technology. Coming up, George Papanikolaou. Welcome to the stage, Rachel Parnham. Coming up, Despina Periclius, who's received her bronze medallion, silver medallion, was on student leadership, the formal committee, and the yearbook committee. Coming up, Alessia Perry, who's received her bronze medallion and an achievement in sport. Please come to the stage Isaac Crash, who has received a bronze medallion, silver medallion, gold medallion, platinum medallion, and a first in PDHPE, first in food technology, was on the yearbook committee, the formal committee, and student leadership. And I'm so sorry that I got your name wrong. Welcome up Yash Rai. Bronze medallion, silver medallion, and gold medallion. Please come to the stage, Mohammed Rajani. You have received your bronze medallion, silver medallion, gold medallion, platinum medallion, and his first in physics and first in mathematics extension too. James Ritzkala, please come to the stage. Ivana Rogic, who has received her bronze medallion, silver medallion, gold medallion, achievement in sport, and was house captain of Freeman. Come to the stage, Sarah Rustam, who has received her bronze medallion. Siobhan Sammy, please come to the stage. Welcome up Ibrahim Sari, who has achieved an achievement in sport. Welcome to the stage, Paige Saunders, who has received a bronze award. Welcome to the stage, Zoe Sayaluni, who has received a bronze medallion, silver medallion, an achievement in sport, and a first in English standard, was on yearbook committee, formal committee, and student leadership. Welcome up Samaya Shafi, who has received a bronze medallion, silver medallion, and gold medallion. Welcome to the stage, Omran Sharif. Hamish Sharma has received a bronze award, a silver award, a gold award, and a platinum medallion, and a first in investigating science. Congratulations, Riyansha Sharma, who has received a bronze award. Welcome to the stage, Sakshi Shukla, who has received a bronze award, silver award, a first in ancient history, and a first in legal studies. Congratulations. Come on up, Ikra Siddiqui, who has received a bronze award, silver award, gold award, platinum award, and a first in English extension too. Please welcome to the stage, Jared Sim. And please welcome to the stage, Inderpal Singh. Oh. come on up, Kaushik Singh, who has received a Bronze Award, Silver Award, Gold Medallion, a first in Engineering Studies, a first in Economic, and was on Yearbook Committee, Formal Committee, and Student Leadership. Congratulations to Nishal Singh, who has received a Bronze Award. Please come on up, Nitish Singh, who has received a Bronze Award, Silver Award, Gold Award, 100% attendance in 2022, and a first in construction. Come on up, Matt Sisavath, who's received a Bronze Award, Silver Award, and a first in visual arts. Please welcome to the stage Alexander Sleeman, who's received a Bronze Award, a Silver Award, and a Gold Award, as well as a first in Society and Culture, was on Yearbook Committee, Formal Committee, and Student Leadership. Congratulations, Carl Squires, who's received a Bronze Award and an Achievement in Sport. Welcome to the stage, Katerina Stefanovsky, who's received a Bronze Medallion, Silver Medallion, and Gold Medallion. Coming up, Peony Sue, who has received a first in Biology, a Bronze Medallion, Silver Medallion, and Gold Medallion. Congratulations to Nadine Tahan, who has received a Bronze Award. Congratulations, Adem Tamel. Welcome to the stage, Lita Tavaga, who has received a Bronze Award, a Silver Award, and an Achievement in Sport. Please come to the stage, Tristan Tai. Congratulations, Leotia, who's received a Bronze Award, a Silver Award, a Sports Achievement, and was House Captain of Thorpe. Congratulations, Gloria Tifa, who's received a Bronze Award, a Sports Achievement, and was House Captain of Thorpe. Congratulations, Nathaniel Tuisuga. Welcome to the stage, Jamie Vojnovsky, who received a Bronze Medallion, Silver Medallion, Student Leadership, was on the Student Leadership Formal Committee and Yearbook Committee, and has achieved a first in Legal Studies and Modern History. Congratulations, Angela Varillas. Congratulations, Kanavara Water. Congratulations, Ahmed Warris. Thank you. Congratulations, Rachel Warner, who has received a bronze medallion, silver medallion, gold medallion, platinum medallion, an achievement in sport, and 100% attendance from 2017 to 2022, and a first in mathematics standard 2. Congratulations to Evan Zenikis. Congratulations to Heidi Zhong, who has received a bronze medallion, silver medallion, an achievement in sport, and was house captain of Thorpe. Congratulations to Edison Zhu, who received a sports achievement, was house captain of Thorpe, and a first in math standard 1. Congratulations to Jenny Zhu, who has received a bronze medallion, silver medallion, gold medallion, a first in history extension, and a first in entertainment. Last but not least, we have William Zhu, who received a bronze medallion, silver medallion, and a gold medallion.
Thank you, Mr. Khan and Ms. McHale, and congratulations to all Year 12. We finally did it. We graduated. We finished school. I would like to invite Mr. Tumor and Mr. Khan to the stage to present the sporting awards.
Okay, well done, Year 12. You've finally made it here. Over the past 6 years, several Year 12 students have achieved many outstanding sporting performances and achievements. Today, I have the privilege to recognise and acknowledge some of these. Our staff, students, and whole school community have been privileged enough to share several sporting successes with you over the years. The first awards that I would like to present are the Rohan Gunasinghe Award. This award is presented to is the School Sports Award, is an award that represents great service to school sport over the student's whole JHS experience. It is awarded to a Year 12 student that has displayed exceptional commitment and dedication to carnivals, knockout sports, gala days, and any other sporting experiences that the school offers. This year, there's two recipients of this award, Zoe Saylooney and Liam Keyes. The next award I'd like to present is the New South Wales Premier's Sporting Challenge Medal is awarded to a student that is recognised for their commitment to fair play, achievement in their sporting discipline as a participant, umpire, trainer, assistant, and or sports leader. Overall contribution to the JHS sporting program and a fan favourite, Emmanuel Madagaya. The next two awards I would like to present are the Senior and Male and Female Sports Person of the Year. Firstly, I'll do the female. This student has excelled both individually and in a variety of team sports. Since Year 7, we have seen her sporting ability and talents across a variety of sports, excelling in touch football, netball, European handball, and most evidently, futsal and soccer. Impressively being selected to represent our school in the Open Soccer Team since Year 8. She continued to compete at all three sporting carnivals, representing not only our school, Bonnera Zone and the Sydney Southwest at many regional swimming carnivals, athletics carnivals and cross-country carnivals throughout the last 6 years. She has represented the Sydney Southwest at the CHS State Cross Country Championships, and these achievements seen her be presented with the Junior Sportsperson of the Year in 2019. Not only has this person achieved so much in sport, she's demonstrated her exceptional leadership skills as the team captain and sports captain of Elliot 2022. Her dedication and motivation to sport has inspired those around her. The recipient of the Senior Female Sportsperson of 2022 is Deanna Corona. Next up, the Senior Male Sportsperson of the Year. This student has demonstrated their positive attitude and talents across several sporting performances also. They have represented the school in both Rugby League and Oztag Carnival, as well as coached junior teams throughout the years. He has thrived when competing in all three sporting carnivals, representing our school, Bonnera Zone, and the Sydney Southwest region at regional swimming, athletics, and cross country. His talents in swimming led to many awards, including Swimming Age Champion, both in year 11 and 12. His motivation, dedication, and overall enjoyment and love for sport should be celebrated and commended. The recipient of the Senior Male Sportsperson is Jake Block.
Thank you, Mr. Trimmer, for presenting the awards. I would now like to ask Mr. Carter to remain on stage and invite Mr. Ellison to the stage to present the Perpetual Awards for 2022.
The final six awards. You go there. Hello again. This brings us to the part of the ceremony where we have the major awards, the perpetual awards. This one is actually not a perpetual award. This is the VET Student of the Year. Just to give you the context of this award, in the Metro Southwest area, we have about 38,000 students who do the VET courses across 10 different VET subjects. 38,000 students learn the trade skills for the industry, and we put the nominations through to the Southwest RTOs. And this year I'm really proud to announce this award because our school student Nishal Singh, in year 12, he was awarded the VET Student of the Year across 38,000 students. So a big round of applause for Nishal. Congratulations, Nishal. The next award is the Boughton Family Quiet Achievers Award. This award is a perpetual shield. This is given to a student in each year group who has worked consistently and diligently to achieve commendable results in a quiet, determined fashion, without necessarily having topped a particular subject, class, or a year. These awards were made by one of our parents, Sue Galvin, one of the founders, members of our PNC committee. This year's Boughton Family Quiet Achievers Award for Year 12 student goes to Ikra Siddiqui. Congratulations, Ikra. Thank you. The next award is the Australian Defence Force Longtan Leadership and Teamwork Awards. This is named in recognition of the place the Battle of Longtan holds in the hearts and minds of Australians and the values the veterans displayed on that day. This award is given to a student in year 10, 11, and 12. Students are selected by the executive committee for regularly demonstrating the values outlined by the award selection criteria within their school and the local community. I'm really proud to announce the winner for the ADF Longtan Leadership and Teamwork Award to Isaac Quash in year 12. The next award is also the Australian Defence Force Longtan Future Innovators Award. This award recognises the recipients for their contributions and their abilities in the science and mathematics fields while highlighting the values of the Defence Forces. Strong focus on the STEM skills and STEM career opportunities within defence. I'm proud to announce Edwin Pangsayer to be the recipient of the ADF Longtan Future Innovators Award. And the final award for the night, the most prestigious award for year 12s, is the 2022 Austin Mackell Prize for the Ducks of the School. This award is named in the honor of Austin Mackell, John Edmondson's platoon leader. Austin Mackell was a man of great intelligence and great achievements. It is a great honor for our school to have his name connected to the prize for the Ducks of John Edmondson High School. The school community is thankful to Austin Mackell's family for allowing us this privilege of doing so. This award goes to a student for exceptional achievement in the courses of study named after Austin Mackell. Congratulations to Carice Kupungse for being awarded the Ducks of the School. As the Ducks of the School, Carice receives a $1,000 scholarship from the school, which is attached to this award. Congratulations, Carice. In saying that, there are also three $1,000 scholarships that will be awarded on the annual presentation night later in the year to year 12 students. Thank you. I am proud of each and every one of you for who you are. It has been a pleasure to see you all grow into fine young men and women over the years. And I'm absolutely proud of what you have achieved, not just in year 12, but throughout your high school career. I wish you all the best. I wish you every success in life. Go achieve bigger and better things. Make yourself and your families proud. I am absolutely proud of you all.
I think just wish you all the best in your HSC exams and whatever you do beyond.
Be good possums and have great lives.
Go out, take the world by the throat, stomp it. Good luck.
Year 12, best of luck with your exams. I'm wishing you lots of good fortune in the future. Go out and have wonderful lives. Make a big impact on the world. Take care.
The reason I've got a big smile on my face is because I love this job. So please try and find something you're passionate about. Follow your goals and don't let anyone tell you you can't do it, because believe me, you can.
Look, best of luck. You know, do what you want to do. Try and work out what it is you want to do. Spend time with that and, best of luck with everything.
I always think just do something that you enjoy and that you love. Be kind to each other and take away the memories that you made and look back fondly of them, and I think you'll do great. And I think every single one of you will find your niche and will excel in life. So best of luck.
You know what you want to do, good luck and all the best. Thank you.
Live good lives,
make good choices, don't do drugs. You've graduated high school. Well done, Year 12.
12? You may not see the people you're amongst now, but just be the best you can be and make the world the best place it can be. Try your best. Try your best.
Take every opportunity that you get in your life, because you only get one life, so just make it the best that you can.
Bye, Year 12. Good luck. Find your ikigai. Go look it up, what it means. Gambatte.
Just good luck, be safe, have fun, and don't do anything horrible in life.
Just be happy.
Good luck to all of you. Make sure you put good efforts in preparing for your exams and everything. And our hopes are with you. You are the future of my country. And put your best efforts and make sure you feel yourself proud of whatever you do. And we make sure we all are proud of you. Thank you.
Good luck. I'm sure you're going to do us all proud. And I'll see you later on.
Hey guys, I just want to say that I'm going to miss you a lot. Some of you, the ones I taught, they have a very special place in my heart. Love you, and I wish you all the best. Bye.
Congratulations to you all. All the best for the future.
Year 12, you've done well to get this far, and wish you all the best for the future.
Congratulations and all the best for the future. Hope to see you.
I'm going to miss you guys so much, so good luck in the world, and yeah, best of luck.
Life is going to be like that. It's going to throw a lot of challenges at you, but persevere in everything that you do, and that is going to make you as a person. Wish you all the best. Sorry to see you go.
Congratulations.
And good luck.
Year 12. 2022.
Mum loves you. Dad loves you. And I love you. Good luck.
Goodbye and good luck, Year 12.
We would like to invite Mr. Khanna back on the stage to present a very special award.
Thank you, Mr. Letson. I would like to, on behalf of our school community, like to show it's a small token of appreciation for what Mr. Letson does for us. Day in, day out, he's a staunch supporter of public education and supports us in so many different ways. Thank you for giving up your valuable time to come to this occasion and making it very special for us. Thank you.
Now, Isaac and I would like to say a few words, but first, could Mr. Patterson and Ms. McHale please make their way to the stage? Thank you for the devoted time and care you have exemplified for us across 6 years of schooling. I know we were a tough grade and hard to handle, but hopefully you enjoyed having us as your year group to look after. As a token of our appreciation and on behalf of the class of 2022, we would like to present you with our graduation gifts to thank you.
...2,062 days ago, a group of young, eager kids walked through the gates of John Anderson High School. With squeaky voices, fresh uniform, and little knowledge of the high school environment, we found ourselves getting lost in the classroom blocks, carrying bags bigger than most of us, and trying to figure out if it was week A or week B, But one thing we could not prepare ourselves for was the growth and discovery that the high school journey entails.
Good afternoon, principal, distinguished guests, friends, family, and fellow graduates. Thank you for coming to celebrate this graduating class of 2022. We couldn't have asked for more support than our parents to be with us on this memorable day. Here we are. Who would have thought this day would come so soon? From counting down to when each period ends back in year seven, to years quickly passing by, which soon turned into terms, into months, into days, until now. Along with the world we live in today, being plagued with dangers like the pandemic, global warming, facial acne, high school stress, and TikTok fame, despite all the odds, we still managed to graduate. So congratulations to everyone for being here today.
The journey of high school is painted with laughs, happiness, stress, anger, and excitement, basically a rollercoaster of emotions. I could have not made it here without the unconditional love from my parents, my mom, my dad. Thank you for the confidence, the unlimited support, the honesty, the courage you have instilled in me. Your wholehearted encouragement significantly inspired me to be persistent, determined to work towards my success. You taught me to bounce back harder when life gets tough, but most importantly, to never lose sight of who I am and to stay true to myself. I want to extend my sincere appreciation to the amazing teachers and principals, from the captivating and insightful classes to the laughs and the conversations that fill each room, to the late night assignments and all these memorable and unforgettable experiences. Also, thank you to the extra time that you spent marking my regular emails, asking for feedback, and for that, I strongly protest that you deserve better pay as well. I do want to thank one particular teacher, Ms. Newman. Your support, your encouragement means the world to me. Thank you for your generosity, your ingenuity, for always going the extra mile in checking in and empowering me to succeed. Your nurturing spirit and your radiant trust has inspired me to find confidence in myself. You taught me to back myself up at all times and to be the most tenacious and authentic version of myself. To the feeder, you're one of my first friends I made at high school. You were my peerist buddy, my partner in crime, and I cannot imagine this role as captain with anyone else but you. I think if we were to go back now, or 2,062 days ago, and tell our Year 7 selves that 6 years' time we will be standing here, I think we would have just laughed and stared blankly at each other. Our energies complement each other so well, and I am beyond grateful to call you my best friend.
No, I don't want to stop there.
I would like to thank all the teachers who have been there for me, supporting me along the way, especially Mr. Clayton, Ms. Coluccio, Mr. Lloyd, Mr. Griffiths, Ms. Zulik, and Ms. Young for believing in me and encouraging me to work hard at all times. I would especially like to thank Isaac for being there by my side since year seven. He has been there for me through everything. Who would have ever thought that we would become school captains of John Ed? Also to my Indian girls, Rhea, Sakshi, and Dia. Without you guys, I wouldn't have survived this place. Thank you for putting up with me and making my high school experience more enjoyable all these years. Also my family for providing me with love and support by never letting me down and supporting every decision in my life. You have taught me to stop doubting myself and help boost my confidence, so thank you and I love you for that.
John Edmondson High School. It has been a conglomerate of vastly memorable experiences that have shaped this distinct journey. A momentous journey that a part of me is afraid of letting go. My journey begins with fun and meeting new people, adapting to the new school life, timetables and different subjects, asking when the next PE lesson is, or do we have maths today? I was so new to everything that all I wanted to do was surround myself with excitement. Over the times, these years flew past as questions changed to what subject did you choose? Did you finish last night's homework? How much have you studied? and coming to school with heavy bags under our eyes than on our backs. Yes, studying is mostly independent. However, the late night FaceTimes, our valuable study decisions, and last minute rush to help each other before an exam are truly unforgettable moments that capture the chaos of high school, a chaos that is irreplaceable. A striking highlight for me definitely has to be my 6 years in SRC. I cannot believe I've come onto this stage several times each year to host assemblies, and this is my very last one. It is inevitable how grateful and thankful I am for the opportunities SRC has provided. It has significantly built my self-confidence, my voice in advocacy, and has helped me find my passion to be a leader. From the behind-the-scenes preparation weeks prior to events, to the setup, the lunchtime and activities, to the intense unit games that follow each event, truly, these are experiences I wish I can repeat. Special mention to Ms. Davidson, Mr. Dwyer, and Ms. Zulik for the excellent mentorship that has meant, that has motivated and encouraged me in profound ways to be the best leader I can be. One that never deviates from the challenge, instead taking them with a head held high and looking to bring awareness and inspire change. Most importantly, I will forever remember the laughs, the joys, and the unique conversations that blanket every classroom, recess and lunch, stories filled with cultivated dreams, aspiring and meaningful chats, and the laughs that put us on the floor and made our stomachs hurt that have emerged within these walls. I will forever miss the natural conversations with friends and teachers, and by senior years, we knew each other so well that these experiences I genuinely never want to let go. This journey is filled with tremendous life, inspiring changes, and will forever hold a special place in my heart.
You finally start to learn who you are when you're a teenager, and suddenly the years go by in a blink of an eye and you see yourself graduating as an adult. Starting our school life, no one ever told us how badly someone can break your heart, or that sometimes our friends don't always stay our friends, or the amount of drama we have to put up with. The people around us spoke highly of responsibility and growing up, but it never meant anything until now. This is it. We find ourselves here, now graduating after 13 years of being stuck in the same routine 5 days a week. Today we woke up for the very last time at 7:30 a.m., put on our uniform, and walked inside the school for the very last time. When I look back on the 6 years in high school, I can't deny it. There have been many highs and lows. No, I'm not going to miss the unnecessary homework, the crowded hallways when changing classes, and the unnecessary stress for the HSC. However, there are many memories we will cherish forever as a grade. The year 10 formal, which was basically a rave, the year 8 camp, the excursions, picnic day, and the massive water fight where we all got absolutely soaked. COVID being one of the underlying factors that have impacted our year 10 life, in which we all woke up at 2 p.m. to battle the tens of Canvas announcements every single day. All the laughs and random conversations with people I would never see myself talking to in my life, just the normal random chats with teachers and peers, I'm gonna miss it so much.
Six years, so many stories have been created. And what is unique to us with all we did is that we did it at John Innocent High School. The beginning of our stories started here, whether you liked it or not, and these stories are worth sharing and listening to. We are not the same people that walked in 2,062 days ago, and the journey has brought significant growth. No, I'm not referencing puberty, or the beards on the boys' face, or the lashes on the girls' eyes. I'm talking about the growth in our characters. Walking out today, I hope we can all take home the cultivated memories that have painted our journey at John Edinson High School. It is indescribable how much I will miss this place. The friendships, the teachers, the staff, the environment that have enriched my life with and presented experiences that I will forever cherish. At the end of it, it did not matter what we were doing, whether we were studying, the petty arguments, the playfulness, the spontaneous and exciting chats, and the laughs that carried across the class. It was the people that were here with that made this experience so worthwhile. The realization that the high school journey is coming to an end and nobody knows what journey awaits, my last advice as captain is to make your own journey, a journey to your next destination.
I may sound corny or whatever, but I will truly miss each and every one of you, even if we never spoke. We have all grown up together, shared both joy and tears, and are now closing this chapter in our lives. Remember, you are not alone in this journey. We are all venturing out together. Life doesn't stop when we receive our certificate. We must still continue to develop and grow as individuals, I wish the best upon each and every one of you for whatever career you choose to accomplish. I love you all. Good luck in life. Here's to the best graduating class John Ed will ever get. It has been an absolute honour to represent this amazing school and our grade as your school captain.
From the bottom of our hearts, we wish you all the very best.
This is Davina Bardi.
This is Isaac Watch.
Your school captains for 2022, the best school captain John Anderson will ever get, and we are signing out. Thank you.
Our final role for being John Edmonton's High School captains for 2022 is to hand over our crowns to the future leaders of this school. The role of the school captain requires distinct qualities to be a leader and an active voice for the school community. It gives us great pleasure to announce the new school captains for 2023, Marco Milutovic and Sienna Robinson. We wish you all the best as our new captains for John Edmonton High School.
Good afternoon, everyone. As captains of our primary school, we were both extremely excited and proud when Mr. Khan announced our names for captaincy. But at the same time, we knew that there were big shoes to fill. It has been an inspiration to watch your cohort progress through John Edmonton High School from the younger peer perspective. We have learned so much and look forward to growing our U group, but the school as a whole. Although this growth would not be possible without our peers, our teachers, deputies, year advisors, and of course, the current leadership team and our principal, Mr. Khanna.
To Davida and Isaac, Sienna and I are honored to be your successors and are sad that we have to say goodbye to such a wholesome group. You have definitely set a high standards with confidence, courage, and dedication. However, today we only want to say an overall big congratulations to the class of 2022. We wish you good luck and all the best in achieving your future goals. Thank you. Finally, a performance of the song End of the Road by Boys to Men by Tessie Moala to celebrate the final moments of the graduating class of 2022.
To see forever. goodbye to yesterday.
Parents, wait, what do we say?
Wait, we have to say thank you. Thank you, everyone, for attending today's memorable event. Thank you. Would parents please exit by the back door, and students exit by the front door? And thank you, everyone, for attending.
How do I say goodbye to what we had? The good time that made us laugh, I'll wait back.